Hello! Today we're going to talk about binary numbers and dip switches and how you sometimes need to use those when you're doing lighting. We'll also cover some weird little inconsistencies that can crop up when you're dealing with binary. You're probably familiar with counting in decimal. Deci comes from the Latin decimus, which means a tenth. It's also where we get words like decade or decimate. It's a pretty common system because humans, barring accident, generally have 10 fingers. Although the Babylonians did use a base 60 system, which is why 60 and multiples of 60 crop up sort of weirdly commonly. Like you have 60 seconds to a minute, 60 minutes to an hour, 360 degrees in a circle. To count in decimal, you start with zero. You have nothing. No things. Then you go from 1 to 9. Now when you get to 9, you've run out of numbers, unless you're Babylonian. But in decimal, 9's as high as we can go. So what we do is we then say that this is the ones place. So everything, this number times 1, how many single items we have. The next one is the tens place. So for example, if we had a 2 here, this would be 2 times 10. Two groups of 10 plus a group of 9, and that's how many things we have. If we then run out here, we just go over 1, multiply by 10, and say this would be 400, 4 groups of 100, 2 groups of 10, 1 group of 9. That's how many things we've got. If we then run out of space again, we just keep going, 1,000, 10,000, and so on. This generally works fine for us. We got from the ancient Egyptians through the 1940s counting by tens. Most of us still count by tens. We even started building computers that calculated using decimal numbers and mechanical cogs because we hadn't figured out this whole electricity thing yet. These ranged from the things like Babbage's difference engine, which was huge and impractical and never actually finished it, to the Curta calculator, which was adorable and fit in the palm of your hand and was sold commercially for 2 decades. Amusingly, they were both hand-cranked, although you were probably less likely to throw your back out using the Curta. Modern electronic computers don't have little cogs in them, although that would be cool. They have electronic switches, which can be either on or off, 1 or 0. So they need to be able to count and do math using only 1 and 0. So once again, we start with 0. We have nothing. No things. We then go to 1. We have 1 thing. Hooray! We are also out of numbers, because we've only got our switches. We can turn them on or off. We've only got 2 numbers to work with. So what we do is we once again say that this is our ones place, except instead of multiplying it by 10, we multiply it by 2. And so now, to count to 2, we have a 0 in the ones place and a 1 in the twos place. If we want to go to 3, we have a pair of things and a single thing. Total of 3 things. If we need to go to the next one, we then double it again and we have 4. So we would have 0 singles, no pairs, and 1 group of 4. If we continued counting upward, 5 would be a group of 4 and a group of 1. 6 would be a group of 4 and a group of 2. 7 would be a group of 4, a group of 2, and a group of 1. And then we've once again run out of numbers, so we double it again. And we just keep going. So you have 8, 16, doubling each time you run out of numbers. Each of these locations that can hold a 1 or a 0 is called a binary digit, or a bit for short. If you have 8 of them, it's called a byte, spelled with a Y because it's fancy. Now, as you start working out the places in binary, you may start to hear numbers that feel kind of familiar, like 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, Normally, we're pretty well isolated from the internal workings of our computers and can generally get through life just fine, not knowing binary. Until you start buying old or cheap lending equipment. Yeah, talking about you. Then you may find yourself face to face with a set of DIP switches. DIP stands for Dual Inline Package and refers to the two sets of leads running down each side of the component. They look like little legs. We now have before us 10 tiny little switches, and somehow we have to use them to set a DMX address. First off, you need to figure out which end is 1 and which direction is on. On equals 1, off equals 0. They should be labeled. Sometimes every switch is labeled, sometimes just the first one. Sometimes on is upside down relative to all the other markings. You then need to convert your DMX address from a decimal number into a binary one. Now, there are apps on your phone that'll do this, and you can do it on your computer. If you're careful, we'll get into that. But maybe your phone battery died. Maybe you dropped it while you were up a scissor lift, and then you ran over it. Your screen protector's not going to help you there. Also, I'm a huge nerd, and I enjoy knowing how to do this stuff, so let's get cracking. We have our powers of 2. We've got 9 of them because there are 9 bits in a DMX address. And we have the DMX address that we want to convert to binary, 215. So we start with the big one, and 256 is bigger than 215. So we put a 0 there. Next, we have 128. Which is smaller than 215. So we subtract 128 from 215, and assuming my math is correct, we get 87, and a 1 in the 128's place. Now, 64 is also smaller or equal than 87. So we subtract 64, leaving us with 23, and we put a 1 in the 64's place. Greater than 23, so we put a 0 in the 32's place. Smaller or equal to 23, so we subtract 16, leaving us with 7. Eight is larger than 7, so we put a 0 in the 8's place. 4, leaving us with 3, and we put a 1 in the 4's place. And we can subtract 2, which leaves us with 1. So we put a 1 in the 2's place. And we can subtract 1, so we put a 1 in the 1's place. And now we are at 0. And you can repeat this for whatever number you've got. Just if you can subtract it, do so, put a 1 there. If you can't, put a 0. If, for example, like let's say you were converting 256 to binary, 256 minus 256 is 0, so you would just put a 1 in your 256 place, and then zeros for all the rest of them. You then go to your DIP switches, and set them with on equals 1 and off equals 0. Now, most of the time there are 10 switches and we only need 9 of them, so a lot of the times the last one will change modes. For example, on this light, if you have number 10 on, then the first 9 switches set the DMX address. If you have number 10 off, then it sets it into, you know, a set color or sound reactive mode or not controlled by DMX. So be sure to read your manual or pamphlet. You can also use Excel to convert a decimal number into binary using their imaginatively named dec2bin function. Here, however, is where we encounter one of the stumbling blocks when using binary. There is not universal agreement as to which way you should count. Sometimes you start with the smallest multiple and it increases as you go from left to right. That's what we calculated and what we would use to program this light. Other times, like Excel, it gives you the largest multiple first, and then it decreases as you go left to right. So instead of getting, so if we converted 215, instead of getting 11101010, we would get 01101011, which if we programmed that into that light, would make it think that its DMX address was 470, which is a little bit different. These two competing systems are known as Little Endian and Big Endian, which is a Gulliver's Travels reference. The other thing to watch out for, although this rarely comes up in lighting, is that computer counting starts at zero, normal people counting starts at one. Like, DMX has 9 bits. Normally, the largest number you could store in 9 bits would be 511, but DMX goes to 512. Well, that's because DMX uses 1 to 512 instead of 0 to 511. This annoys computer programmers. But anyway, so now, if you buy the finest DMX LED light that $14 can buy, and find yourself face to face with a set of these guys, you'll know what to do, and what order to do it in. Anyway, that's all for now, and thanks for watching. For our first example, let's use 384. We can subtract 256 from 384. So we put a 1 in the 256 place, and then we subtract 256, leaving us with 128. We can subtract 128, so we put a 1 in the 128's place, and then we subtract 128, leaving us with 0. Since we have reached 0, we put 0 in all the remaining places, and we're done. We then write out our settings, remembering that we go from smallest to largest because we are setting dip switches. Next, let's do something a little smaller. Let's say 50. Now, we cannot subtract 256, 128, or 64 from 50, so we put a 0 in all of those places. We can subtract 32, so we put a 1 in the 32 place, and then we subtract 32, leaving us with 18. We can subtract 16 from 18, so we put a 1 in the 16's place, and then we subtract 16, leaving us with 2. We cannot subtract 8 or 4, so we put a 0 in those two places, but we can subtract 2, so we put a 1 there, and then subtract 2, leaving us with 0. So we put a 0 in the 1's place. We now have our dip switch setting. For our final example, let's do 196. Now you cannot subtract 256 from 196, so we put a 0 there, and move on. You can subtract 128, so you put a 1 there, and then you subtract 128, leaving you with 68. You can subtract 64, so you put a 1 there, and then you subtract 64, leaving us with 4. You cannot subtract 32, 16, or 8 from 4, so you put a 0 in all of those places, and move on. You can subtract 4, so you put a 1 there, and then you subtract 4, leaving us with 0. Since we have reached 0, we put a 0 in the two remaining places. We now have our dip switch settings. Now, let us convert from binary back into decimal. Here, we have a 64, a 32, a 4, and a 2. 64 plus 32 is 96, plus 4 is 100, plus 2 is 102. So this binary number is 102 in decimal. And for our final example, let's convert this binary number into decimal. We have a 128, we have a 16, we have an 8, and we have a 1. 128 plus 16 is 144. 144 plus 8 is 152. 152 plus 1 is 153. So this binary number is 153 in decimal.